Hello everybody, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to call some user-defined modules. So how can I do that? First, I create two py files that store some user-defined function about lists. And then I will import the two py files as some user-defined modules. And after I've imported the two py files as modules, I will process some lists by using the methods provided by these modules. The first module will come from a file called operatelist.py. I will have two user-defined functions. The first one is called delete names from a list. And the second one will be to add some names to a particular list. Okay, the first function which is called delete names is doing the deletion of a particular name from the given person list. And the second function called addNames is to add a particular name to the existing list for certain times determined by the times variable here. To do the delete names function, I will do something like this. If the target really exists in the person list, I will remove that name. If it is not the case, I will tell the user that the target is not in the list. And then I will break the while loop. So when somebody is not in the target, when somebody is not in the person list, the addition, the deletion of the names will end. So how about the add names method or function? If a new name is not in the person list, I will do the appending for the number of times defined by the variable called times. After the appending action, I need to shuffle the person list. Since I want to use the shuffle method from the random module, I have to import the random module beforehand. So this completes the first file called operatelist.py. Let me save it. And then I'm going to set up another py file called handlenumbers.py. So in this py file, I will have two functions. One is called addNumber. I will pass a list of numbers, and then I specify the starting position. Together with the number of elements after the starting number. What will I return from this function? I would simply add up the numbers from the start index to the index indicated by the start plus number of elements from start. So I will have a partitioned list, and the partitioned list contains some numbers from the start index to the index indicated by start plus num elements from start. And the second function in this py file is called getMean. I simply want to get the mean value of the partitioned list. Okay. I want to create a temporary list called temp list, which is the partitioned list based on these starting index and the index obtained by start plus num elements from start. I need the total to be 0 first, and then I will accumulate the values from the partitioned list called temp list. Okay, this is the accumulation process. So the total variable will be storing the sum of the numbers between the start index and the index indicated by this value. And then I will return the average. Which is equal to the total value divided by the number of elements in the temp list. Okay, let me save it. And then I can use the functions from handlenumbers.py. How can I use it? I can use the handlenumbers.py file, which has a short form called hn. From the hn file, I can use the addNumber method. Or function. Here I would like to add the numbers from the first from the second element to the element indicated by index 1 plus 5 minus 1. So I will be adding the numbers from this element to 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1. So I will add up all these numbers between the second element and the sixth element. we can check the result when I run it later. I can also get the mean value of the same partitioned list. When I use hn.getMean here, it means that I will call the function from the handle.numbers.py file. It means that I will get the average of these five values. Let us see the running result now. Let me save it. Okay, we will have this statement being printed because when we refer to the init name function, we will have an iterative process of the name deletion. If the name is no longer present in the list, I will print a statement out. So team is originally in the list, but I still print out this statement. What's the reason for that? Because this statement will be printed out under two conditions. One is that team has already been removed and completely from the person list. And the second possibility is that team is actually not in the person list. But when we refer to our name list here, team was actually present in the list. So this statement is printed out because the delete names method or function is able to delete both teams completely. And this printing statement tells us that team is already removed completely from the my name list here. And when I print the variable called my name list after calling the delete names function, we can see that the list has no team inside. Okay, and then when we want to add Lily twice into the my name list, we can see that Lily and Lily are added to the list here. Since I used a random.shuffle method, it means that Lily and Lily will not always be at the final two positions. Okay, when we see the value of 90 here, it refers to the sum of these five values. And the average value obtained from these five values is shown on the my average variable here, which is equal to 3.8. My code is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the best solution to the problem. If you can think about any improvement of my code, please post your code on the comment section below the video. And if you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.